History Chapter 10 Ancient India Cultural Points to be discussed 10.1 Chapter 10 in that point 1 Language and Literature 10.2 Life of the People 10.3 Science 10.4 Centers of Education 10.5 Art and Architecture First point, 10.1, language and literature. What is meant by literature? Stories and human experiences were written as literature. These literature were produced in Sanskrit language, Ardha Magadhi language, Pali language and Tamil language. These literature includes religious literature, treatises, grammar, epics, plays, stories, etc. Meaning of treatise. A written work dealing formally and systematically with a subject. Meaning of epics. A long poem. Another meaning, narrating the deeds and adventure of a hero or legendary figure or figures. Another meaning, the past history of a nation. Let us know about Sangam literature. Explanation, meaning of Sangam as per textbook, a gathering of learned men. The literature produced in such gatherings is known as Sangam literature. Sangam literature is the most ancient literature. Meaning of ancient, no longer in existence. In Tamil literature, there are two well-known epics. They are Sillappadhikaram and Manimekhalai. Thus, from Sangam literature, we learnt about political and social life in South India. So, students, I hope Sangam literature is clear to you. Let us know about religious literature. Explanation, religious literature includes Agam Granth, Tipitika and Bhagavad Gita. Let us know about Agam Granth. In that, Jain Agam Granth. Explanation, Jain Agam Granth are written in Prakrit language of Ardha Magadhi, Shauraseni, Maharashtri. Jain Agam Granths are the teaching of Vardhaman Mahavir. Mahapuranas, biographies, stories, etc. are available in Apabhramsha language. Now let us know about the names of some story writers and poets along with their works. Siddhasen Divakar wrote Samay Sutta in Prakrit language. Vimal Suri told a story of Rama in Paumcharya. It was a poem in Prakrit language. Haribhadra Suri's Samairai Chakaha and Udyotan Suri's Kuvalaya Malakaha are the famous works. Now let us know about Tipitika. Tipitika has three parts or Pitaka. The word Pitaka means a basket or collections. Here, Tipitika is known as sections. So it has two meanings. Word Pitaka means a basket or collection. But here Tipitika means sections. Tipitaka. Here clearly Tipitaka is written in Pali language. It has three categories of text. They are Sutta Pitaka, Vinay Pitaka, Abhidhamma Pitaka. Let us know about Sutta Pitaka. Explanation, this includes the text of Gautam Buddha's teaching or sermons. Meaning of sermons, they are suktas or suktam. Next one, Vinay Pitaka. Explanation, the word Vinay means rules. Vinay Pitaka are the rules of behavior which bhikkhus and bhikkhunis in the Bauddha Sangha should follow daily in their life. In short, rules and regulations written for whom? For bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. Okay, next one, Abhidhamma Pitaka. Buddhist doctrine has been explained. Meaning of doctrine, a set of beliefs. A set of beliefs means when we are following Buddhism, there are certain rules, there are certain regulations, there are certain beliefs which we should follow while following Buddhism. A text named Atakatha or Arthakatha is explained in Ti Pitakas and it is very famous. Learned women composed gathas or stories from their own experiences. They are produced in Teri Gatha. Teri Gatha is in Pali language. Teri Gatha means your story, your personal story, your personal experiences is known as Teri Gatha. And Teri Gatha is in written in Pali language. Now in that there is Bhagavad Gita mentioned. Bhagavad Gita is a text of Hindus. It is a part of Mahabharata. Bhagavad Gita tells us about our duty. That is, we have to do our duty without expecting any rewards. It also tells us the path of devotion is open to all. The path of devotion to God is open to all. So now let us know about Adi Shankaracharya. Explanation, Adi Shankaracharya lived in 8th century CE. He gave more importance to knowledge and renunciation. Meaning of renunciation, the formal rejection of something. To reject something, what it is? Specially beliefs, false beliefs. So meaning of renunciation, the formal rejection of something, especially beliefs or false beliefs. Adi Shankaracharya wrote Upanishads, Brahma Sutras and Bhagavad Gita. When he wrote Bhagavad Gita, he also explained the meaning to understand for common people like us. So I hope Adi Shankaracharya is clear to you. Adi Shankaracharya also established four mutts in four directions of India. Places were Badrinath, Dwarka, Jagannath Puri and Sringeri. Now let us know about Kautilya. Kautilya wrote the Arthashastra in which he has discussed what is required for an efficient administrative system. Now let us know about Treatise of Grammar. Meaning of treatise, written work in detail about a particular subject. Sanskrit grammar, Ashtadhyayi, was written by Panini. It can come for name the following. It is considered as one of the best work on Sanskrit grammar. So which is the best book on Sanskrit grammar? Ashtadhyayi. Ashtadhyayi is a Sanskrit grammar book written by Panini. And it is the best book ever. There was another person named Patanjali who wrote Mahabhashya book. And what is written in Mahabhashya book? It explains the principles of Ashtadhyayi written by Panini. Principles means the part which is very hard for us to understand. It can be explained in a very easy manner. Okay, so the basic things written in Sanskrit grammar of Panini is explained in Mahabhashya as well. Now let us know about Arsha and classical epics. Students, we are still discussing about 10.1. So let us know about Arsha and classical epics. Explanation, Arsha means composed by rishis or sages. Ramayana and Mahabharata are the two Arsha epics of ancient India. How? Ramayana was composed by Rishi Valmiki. It means character, the main character was Lord Shri Ram. Mahabharata was composed by Sage Vyas. Its main theme was the war between the Kauravas and the Pandavas. It also tells us about Lord Krishna's life. Mahabharata also tells us about a comprehensive picture of various human sentiments and emotions and consequences. Now, meaning of comprehensive, including all the aspects or elements of something. Meaning of consequences, after effect or result. So, students, sometimes in the history of language, literature and art is the past, but its glory remains forever. Yes or no? For example, yes, Ramayana and Mahabharata. So, such period is called as classical period. Now, let us know some examples of classical period. Raghuvansha and Kumara Sambhava was written by Kalidasa. Kirat Arjuniya was written by Bhairavi. Shishupalvad was written by Mhag. These are some of the famous compositions of ancient period written in the classical Sanskrit. Now, let us know about theatre. India has an old tradition of saying story through songs, music and dance. This has been explained in Natya Shastra by Bharat Muni. When these arts were presented along with supporting dialogues, they are known as theatre. Even these days, you can go and watch a play in the theatre. Yes, students. Some examples of ancient Sanskrit plays are Swapna Vasavadhuta by Bhasa, Abhijnana Shakuntal by Kalidasa are famous even today. Now, let us know about narrative description, explanation. In ancient times, storytelling was used to educate people through entertainment. Some examples of narrative literature are Bruhat Katha, written in Paishachi language by Gunadhya. Gunadhya wrote Bruhat Katha in Paishachi language. Panchatantra, composed by Pandit Vishnu Sharma. Panchatantra storybooks are available in your school library. Students, you can go and read. Bauddha Jataka tales are well known even today. Yes, you can find many stories in your school library as well as on YouTube also. These texts are translated into many different languages. So, students, we were still discussing 10.1 and we learnt about Sangam literature, religious literature, treatise on grammar, Arsha and classical epics, theatre and narrative literature. Let us know about the next point, 10.2, life of the people explanation. In literature of ancient India, how the people lived at the time is also mentioned. Trade was progressing internally and as well as externally. Society was divided into different castes. There were traders and artisans organizations. These organizations were known as Shrenis. Trade was carried out on sea as well as on land routes too. Indian goods were in great demand, like fine textiles, ivory, precious stones, spices, beautifully made earthen pots were in great demand in the foreign countries. Now let us know about food. The main crops of India consist of rice, wheat, barley, lentil. The diet of people included food made from crops besides meat, fish, milk, ghee and fruits were also consumed. Now let us know about the clothes. People mostly wore cotton garments. Silk and woolen garments were also worn. Their clothes are similar to today's clothes like dhoti, uparane, mundase, sari, etc. The concept of stitching clothes in India was introduced by Kushana kings. Now let us know the next point, 10.3, science. Explanation: Indian medical science is known as Ayurveda. It is a very old tradition. Now what is Ayurveda? Ayurveda sees and understands the symptoms of illness, its diagnosis and treatment, and how to prevent any sort of illness. For example, Jivaka was a famous Vaidya from King Bimbisara's court. Do you remember? Yes. Now let us know about Charak Samhita. Charak Samhita was written by Vaidya Charak. It contains detailed information about clinical diagnosis and pharmacy. Let us know about Sushruta Samhita. Sushruta Samhita was written by famous surgeon Sushruta. It tells us more about diagnosis and different ailments and different causes leading to injuries, fractures, different types and various types of surgeries required for them. So in short, Sushruta Samhita was much better than Charak Samhita. Sushruta Samhita was translated into Arabic language. The name of this book was Kitab-e-Susud. So students, now let us know about Vagha Bhat. Vagha Bhat was also a well-known personality. He also wrote many books. His well-known and important books are the Ashtanga Sangraha, the Ashtanga Hridaya Samhita. Now let us know about Bauddha Bhikkhu Siddha Nagarjuna. He was also very famous. He also wrote a book, Rasa Ratnakara. This book tells us about chemicals and metals. So students, let us know about mathematics and astronomy. Explanation. In ancient India, Indians have studied mathematics and astronomy at a very great level. So, let us see an example of Aryabhat. Indians were the first to use numerals 1 to 9. They invented the concept of decimal system. There was a scientist named Aryabhat who wrote book Aryabhatiya. It includes many formulas and mathematical operations. He was the first to state that Earth revolves around the Sun. Now, let us know about Varahamihir. Varahamihir wrote the famous text Pancha Siddhantika in 6th century AD. This text tells us about the principles of Indian astronomy, Greek astronomy, Roman and Egyptian civilization. Let us know about Brahmagupta. A mathematician named Brahmagupta lived in 7th century CE. His texts were translated into Arabic language. So students, I hope mathematics and astronomy is clear to you. Let us see the next point. Centers of education. 10.4 centers of education. Explanation. There are many good universities in ancient India. Students from other countries came here for their studies. First one, Takshashila University. Takshashila University is in Pakistan. Archaeological evidence says that in 6th century, this city was established. Many famous personalities studied at Takshashila universities and they were Jivaka, Chandragupta Maurya, Panini, Greek historians, Chinese Buddha, Fa Yan, etc. This university provided education in various subjects such as Vedic literature, Buddhist philosophy, economics, logic, etc. Now let us know about Varanasi. Do you know students how Varanasi got its name? The river Ganga has two tributaries, Varana and Asi. The city is located between Varana and Asi. In this way, this place got its name as Varanasi. Varanasi provided education in areas of Vedic as well as Jain and Buddhist philosophy. Now let us know about Valabhi. Valabhi was an ancient city in Saurashtra, Gujarat, from 5th to 8th CE. It was providing education of Jain and Buddhist philosophy. Chinese Bauddha Bhikkhu Yuan Chuang and Itzing had visited Valabhi. Now let us know about Nalanda University. Explanation. The remains of Nalanda University can be seen at Patna city in Bihar. Emperor Harshavardhan donated generously to this university. According to the records made by Yuan Chuang and Itzing, this university can accommodate thousands of students. Its library has 1,000 of books. For taking admission, students has to pass an entrance exam at the gate of Nalanda University. Now let us know about Vikramshila University. Vikramshila University is located at Bagalpur in Bihar. It was established by king named Dharmapal in 8th century. It has 6 viharas. Each has its own separate entrance. Now let us know about Kanchi. Explanation. During the rule of Pallava dynasty, Kanchi in Tamil Nadu emerged as a center of education. It provided education of teaching and learning of Vedic, Jain and Buddhist text. So students, we covered Takshashila University, Varanasi, Valabhi, Nalanda University, Vikramshila University and Kanchi. I hope this point is clear to you. Let us see the next point, art and architecture. Explanation about architecture. Indian architecture progressed during Maurya and Gupta periods. Stone pillars erected by Emperor Ashoka are famous even today. The stupa at Sanchi and cave sculptures at Udayagiri, Khandagiri, Karla, Nashik, Ajanta, Ellora, etc. are also well known. Now let us know about art. Art of images was developed during Gupta period. Temple architecture developed during Chalukya and Pallava dynasties in South India. The temples of Mahabalipuram is an example of architecture. The art of making bronze images of deities emerged during the period of Pallavas. The iron pillar at Mehroli near Delhi is also an example of metallurgy of the ancient Indians. Meaning of metallurgy, heating of metals or working on metals to give it a desired shape or properties. So students, in this chapter we therefore came to know the ancient Indian culture was very prosperous and advanced. Thank you.